Hi, I have almost shared about 20 videos giving various insights and strategies on handling the post-lockdown and COVID situation. So one of my client recently communicated and asked me, Prakash, you are giving so many inputs, which one am I supposed to use? I told him, one size doesn't fit all. It's like a buffet. I'm giving you a wide range of choices so that you'll be able to ascertain and find out which suits you the best. If you have watched all the 20 videos till now and a few more to come on this triple S series, as we call it, Survive, Stabilize and Surge Ahead, which is the model that we prefer to implement as a support mechanism for all our clients. You will understand that each business has its own intricacies, and specifically, no one single person has a crystal ball in his or her hand to say with certainty, this is how things will unfold. We all can at best make certain educated guesses. There will be an amount of risk taking irrespective of any path that you decide to take. But it is up to you in your wisdom, because you know your business best and decide what is the right path. In today's video, I want to share three insights that I want you to focus upon specifically in the short to midterm. The number one, as I always say, cash is king. So, the point number one for you to do is, please create a daily tracker of your expenses based on your monthly outflow and your monthly projected revenue. And do not wait for 1 week, 2 weeks, 4 weeks for you to take a call on how to optimize on revenue. Which expenses to cut, which expenses that you can delay a bit. Specifically, you have only two components, fixed and variable expenses. It is up to you to decide on a daily basis. If you are watching the video today, make a projection for next 1 month revenue. Out of the revenue, you know how much actually is your gross contribution. In one of the earlier videos, I mentioned that roughly, depending upon the business, it varies between 15 to 30%. On that gross contribution, how much can you allocate for the expenses for a month and then bring it down to a day and track it at the end of the day, every day, for you to know, so that you make real-time decisions, real-time database decisions, instead of waiting for 2 weeks and 4 weeks and hoping that things will change later. It may, but it's better to take it one step at a time. So step number one, point number one for you is to consider a daily expense tracker. Point number two is more of a short to midterm kind of an outlook. I want you to look at the relevance of your current business model. Irrespective of whatever business line you might have been, even if you are still in a business model which is relevant today, yet by making a few mistakes, you might lose out. Even assuming you are in a business which does not at this moment make sense for you to continue, by just altering the business model a bit, it might help you to survive, stabilize, so that you can surge ahead later. So please relook with the help of experts, friends, colleagues, your senior staff, members, what is my current business model? Is it relevant for the day? Will it be relevant 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 months down the line? Or do I have to relook? We have looked at 2 points till now. The first is daily expense tracker. The second is for you to relook at your current business model. Point number three is, I would urge you to make three plans, considering how It's likely to go based on experts' inputs coming. Create 3 business plans, one for 0 to 3 months, that is starting from now for the next 3 months. Where will my revenue come from? What kind of a product change or service change I have to do? What kind of expenses I have to manage? How do I stay at least at break even for 3 months? At the end of 3 months, something else might change. Still, go ahead and make a 3 to 9 month business plan. If things proceed the way in which it is progressing, how would I, having now more or less crossed the survival stage or maybe few more months to go, how do I move to the stabilization stage? That can be done in the 3 to 9 months bucket. Make a business plan on how to stabilize. Both in the survival and stabilization stage, your focus fundamentally is on breaking even. If you break even, you have done a great job. The third business plan is for 9 to 18 months. Once you have stabilized and you have crossed the critical stage where the vaccine is ready, people are now much more mentally freer and calmer to work without knowing where the savior medicine is going to come from, you can move to the third stage, which is the takeoff or the surge ahead stage. Make a business plan for 9 months to 18 months. A typical business plan consists of right from re-strategize products and service, your revenue streams, the new markets, everything that you can think of. There are various ways in which business plans can be made. Enough templates are available on the internet. Have a look. Make 3 business plans, as I said, 0 to 3 months, 3 months to 9 months, 9 months to 18 months. 0 to 3 months is on survival stage. 3 to 9 months is more on stabilization stage. 9 to 18 months is on surge ahead or takeoff stage. Just to sum up the 3 points, daily tracker of expenses to be made and reviewed every day end on a real-time database. Reviewing your business model to check the relevance of your product and service and what you need to do to revisit them. And then a 3-bucket business plan for survival stage of 0 to 3 months, stabilization stage of 3 to 9 months, and surge ahead or takeoff stage of 9 to 18 months. Do it right away so that you have enough time before things get harder. I wish you the very best, and we are here to support you in whatever you want to do in this 3-stage lockdown post-COVID scenario of survive, stabilize, and surge ahead. Thank you.